Today I have the pleasure of speaking with Greg Andrews of Search Minerals. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank you, Tracy.
So Greg, you're one of the top North American experts on rare earths. Can you tell me why you are so well positioned to take advantage of the crisis with the U.S.-China trade wars?
Tracy, what's happening in this space right now is there has been some more renewed interest in the rare earths to create a rare earth supply chain in North America. And that's really sitting well with us. We've continued to work when no one else really was in the space, and so we're looking for these opportunities now.
And of course, you have one of the most substantial board and management teams for experts in the rare earth industry. And I saw that you just announced a new consultant. I gotta ask you, why? You already have the top specialist.
Yeah, so we're blessed with, we have Dr. Randy Miller, who takes care of our resource, which is very important. We have Dr. David Dreisinger that takes care of our processing. So our next consultant we hired was a rare specialist from Japan, Kaz Machida, and he's looking for us to now get down into, further into the supply chain, which is really our next step to create our, to develop our project.
And I know you've always been one of those understated kind of CEOs. So can you just tell the Investor Intel audience that's maybe new to rare earths who you really are?
So we got into the game back in 2012 when 500 or 600 other companies did, and we still managed to continue to work. We have a district in Newfoundland and Labrador, and that's what we've continued to work on. We just announced a second resource in our district, which is really our game changer because it takes our project from a 14-year life mine to probably a generational play, which has excited both the government, Newfoundland and Labrador, and the Canadian governments.
So is this the Foxtrot project that you're making reference to?
This is the Deep Fox project that we finally drilled and created a resource. We just announced a resource on that property recently.
Of course, with all of the news, the global news about what's happening with the U.S. and China, when do you think that this is actually going to translate to prices on the rare earth stocks? Because there's only a few core players in the industry presently.
Yeah, I can. There's a couple drivers in this market. One is the geopolitical risk with the U.S.-China trade wars and the cooperation with the U.S. and Canada for developing a supply chain in North America, but also the drivers of the electrification of vehicles, the wind turbines, and the actual uses of the rare earths will also drive those prices forward in the coming years.
Okay, so short term, what should we as shareholders or potential shareholders anticipate in the next quarter other than hopefully, these prices being driven by the news?
So for the upcoming months, what we're doing is we're just finishing our optimization of our pilot plant, and our next goals will now be developing a demonstration plant to create more products for separations to get further down in the supply chain. That will be our focus in the next 6 months.
Well, Greg, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it as always.
Thank you, Tracy.